My name is Debbie Williams. I own Home Video Studio in Erlanger, Kentucky. I started this business in September of 2011. Before operating a home video studio, my background was pretty varied, but my degree was in graphic design, photography, with a side major in music. So I went on to be a graphic designer professionally for corporate, working in the daily newspaper actually in Cincinnati, Ohio for many, many years. I left that to freelance as a graphic designer and photographer. Was not real happy with the results I was getting. It was a little, you know, ebb and flow, not too much work or a lot of work, not very consistent. I have to say that I have been in the corporate world for 26, 27, 28 years before I even started freelancing. There were days where I did not want to get up and drive downtown, fight the traffic, and then fight the corporate politics and things that happen in the corporate world. It got to where I was not happy going to work. I enjoyed what I did. I loved my work. I loved what I did, but I didn't enjoy going to work. That's when I knew I had to make a change, and I did. I made a change to freelance. It wasn't what I wanted. I found Home Video Studio, and I will honestly say, since opening my studio doors, I have not regretted one day that I've had to go to work. Even if I have to work late hours, I didn't regret it. I love what I do. I enjoy doing it, and it has been a blessing to me. So my husband and I felt like we had a big decision to make because there was an opportunity in front of us to start a business, to be an entrepreneur, and to make a go out of something that I enjoy doing, which was photography, videography, and creating things for people that were precious to them. So we felt like we had a big decision to make. We talked about it. Considered our options, our pros and cons, that kind of thing. But in the end, we felt like there were more pros and cons. I will say that we pretty much had our mind made up before going to show and tell. It was just a matter of solidifying with us that what we heard and what we saw was going to fit with our vision, which it did. So we were pretty much sold before going. But going to show and tell absolutely did make our mind up. So as far as family goes, my husband is very supportive of me. He encouraged me. He went with me to show and tell. He did not go with me to advanced training, but he has been with me every step of the way, encouraging me, talking with me, and helping me make sense of the pros and cons as far as what I wanted to do. He does see the long hours sometimes that I work, but he's still very encouraging to me, and it's very helpful to have that support by my side. I started Home Video Studio as a part-time business. I was still working a couple part-time jobs as well as freelancing. And I wanted some time to get it started, get the momentum going without losing my current income as it was. I've been in this business now 4.5 years. I will say that by now I am working this business full time. I do still carry a part-time job, but it's only maybe 4 or 5 hours a week. It's not very much. It's something that I enjoy doing and I'm going to continue doing it, and it fits into my schedule. So I have migrated from a part-time business to a full-time business. Really my favorite profit center is a photo keepsake. And that could be anything from a proposal to a wedding to a graduation to nearly anything that our customers come in the door and ask for. And I like those because it enables me to listen to my customer, whether they bring a box of photos or they just bring an idea. It allows me to take their idea, take their thought processes, and immediately start coming up with ideas for them to bring their story to life. And I think one reason why I really like it is that when I do proof that video to my customer, nine times out of 10, they leave with tears in their eyes, and that just makes me happy. I like that because I know that I've struck an emotional chord, and that's what I want to do. Basic training. That was the first time that I was going to be gone for a week. We went to Indianapolis. I would say there was probably five or six other studios there that week, none of which I had known, but all of which I got to know very well during that week. We learned everything, the nuts and bolts of the business, everything from answering the phone, how to answer that phone, how quick to answer that phone, what to say, recommendations, how to overcome objections, learning about our profit centers, what we sell, how to sell them, what is most profitable, what isn't. We learned a whole lot. In fact, we even took some time to create our first photo keepsake and show them to the group, which was quite interesting. But at least it got us to do something and to create something so that we didn't leave wondering, can we really do this? So I felt like I left anyway with a notion that I could do this, I did do it, and I had a lot of tools in my toolbox in order to go ahead and start. It works out quite well for me. I'm fortunate to be able to dedicate a portion of the house to the studio. I do have a dedicated studio door, so I don't feel like there are people in and out of my house proper where people are living. That works out nice. Most everybody that comes in, they see the equipment and they see what I've got set up and they're like, wow, this is a real business. I'm like, yeah, it is a real business. So that works out very well for me. But working from home is very nice because I do still have children at home as young as 10 years old. So the best part of that is when he comes home off the bus from school and I'm home and he knows it. That warms my heart and it makes him feel better too. That's probably the best part of being able to work from home. The best thing for me personally about home video studio, because I am a competitive person, is being able to enter into something called the Hanley Awards, being able to hear your name, maybe not once or twice, but four or five times as a nominee for a certain award, and then to be able to win a Hanley, which these Hanley Awards are like the Oscars. You get dressed to the nines, you have a great meal, and you go through and the winner is, and it's a thrill and it's a rush, not just for you, although that's fantastic, but it's great to see all these other studio owners win, what they win for and their reactions, and I have to tell you, that's probably the best thing for me. So what's really neat about coming to these trainings, and it's something I look forward to, and I know many owners do, is the camaraderie that we have with the different studio owners. You would think maybe that we're all in competition, but we're not. We become great friends and we learn a lot from each other. We bounce things off of each other. In our downtime, we'll go out to eat, we'll go to lunch or dinner, and you know, just have a great time with each other. And we know that by doing that, when we go back to our studios and we're back in our little island, we have somebody that we are comfortable being able to call should we have a question or a problem or something that comes across our desk that maybe we're not too sure. Everybody in this business has different strengths. Everybody has something that they do very, very well, or they have a specialty. So you learn very quickly who to call and who would be very great to answer these questions that we may have. And I think the only way you can have that is by coming to these trainings and getting to know everybody, because we're all in the same position. So get to know who we are and just take advantage of that situation. I think Robert has been in the film industry for a very, very long time. He's seen all sides, behind the camera, in front of the camera, as a studio owner himself, as a one-person operation, as many of us are. He's been there, he's done that, he's seen it, he's grown, he's helped other people grow. I truly believe he does know what he's doing. He is always encouraging us to contact him, to talk to him weekly, daily, whatever it is that we need. I don't think I've ever called him where he said, I don't have time to talk to you. And even if he maybe hasn't had time that minute, he's called me back in 5 minutes. He's always there for us. He does care about us. He he encourages us to come to these trainings. He makes sure that we understand what it is that we're going to be doing when we're here before we're here. He really does seem to care about each and every one of us, and he wants us all to succeed, and I think that is a great thing to have. So ultimately, looking at the pros and cons, looking at the potential, talking to other studio owners currently that had studios, I ultimately made that decision based on this. If I don't try it, I will never know. And so I did. So when somebody calls, and I have had a few people call me, if they were considering opening a home video studio, they want to know firsthand from somebody that runs a business, what's it like? The advice that I would give them is, you know, what is your passion? Do you have a passion for video? Do you have a passion for helping people? Do you have a passion for having your own business and having yourself in control of your destiny and what you want? My advice to them is, you answer yes to those questions, then you definitely ought to consider this business. Mm-hmm.